setting our affection and thanks about this is a church that is sound. Number one, the priority that we talked last Sunday is God. Number two, we talk about the priority of a person, of a group of members of the church, the living organism. The priority is doing the will of God. And number three, we talk about not only doing the will of God, but doing thanks for the kingdom of God. As you recall, the three major things as we studied last Sunday. And we had the what we call the practical sign or application that I was able to communicate to you the message that everything that we do, setting our affection things about from the family, in your work, in your association with people, social, in other words, Christ must be lifted up. And we talk about self is out when it comes to serving God, and Christ is seen in our lives. And the gaze of our allegiance to God and love of service to God is started at home, is started in the church, is started in our relationship with one another. And once this is taken care of and blended peacefully, we're going to have the momentum that translates our faith in a visible reality of our lives, that people would say truly that is a Christian church, because that is a Christian church. They have a Christian heart and there is no God. That's very important. And so today we're going to study vessels for in preparation for God's mastership. Now looking to the condition of the world today, many nations, they are still trying to climb. Some of the nations, they try to be one of the superpowers of the world. If you look back a few years ago, just two nations, one is a very, very small nation, one is a very, very big nation. The big nation with 1.2 billion population will become a superpower in the making, and that is India. The smallest nation in the world, very small, is now superpower. What so precise, intellectual, powerful, even the invention in this is the nation of Israel. They are not the superpower. Now to be able to be part of the superpower of the world, you know what happened? We need good armies and good navies and good air force to be trained. So there's what we call the boot camp, where each aspiring soldiers must go to training. And once they finish that training, it is a written training, and finish, there is one more application where they can embark into the reality and experience of what they had learned must be applied in the local setting of warfare or international warfare. And so there's a book come. I want you to notice as this kind of army that we're talking about, army of the world, there's what we call, there's no instant promotion. After you finish, you'll become an ordinary soldier, a private soldier, first class soldier, a corporal, a staff sergeant, whatever. There is no right away promoted from a private to master. We cannot go that far. There must be a succession of training and understanding by life experiences. There's no shortcut. Now, in the context that we are studying today, these people, they have earned the promotion by following rules of the army, and in most cases, and generally speaking, these people were promoted. I am Filipino, become major. Some Filipino will become admiral in America. Oh, amazing. One is become colonel, from major to colonel. And I know that the son of the pastor, They have earned that through the years, and they were subordinate to the commanding officer. And what happened, when we talk now in the shifting into spiritual matter about, you know, vessel and the master's hands to be used for his glory, there is what they call a higher training for the believers to be tested and proven as soldiers and servants of God in the process. Okay? In the process. Now the Bible says, for the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but it is mighty through God to the pulling down of his strongholds. So our enemy here is not people, but spiritual darkness, spiritual wickedness, what we call spiritual darkness or demons, and then wicked people, influenced by satanic power. So these are our enemy, not people, but spiritual wickedness. And with these weapons, the Bible says, as we go to the first point, as these weapons are being applied, these weapons we conquer the religious ideas and teach them to obey Christ. And you know what? We're all candidates, as vessels and soldiers of Christ. But before the actual combat and fight, the evil world system is contrary to the things of God. The evil spirit is rampant, so many of this by the opinions of them. And the evil people, we must first, number one, as we can see in verse 1, chapter 3, therefore, to take note of the first word, put to death your members which are on earth. Fornication, uncleanness, passion, evil desire, covetousness, which is idolatry. Now the first thing that we can see in those 5 points that Apostle Paul enumerated, itemized, the unveiling of this kind of power, which was being part of us then, but now we are dead in Christ. Number one is to be dead in our evil desire. Dead. Put to death. The word that is put to death. Put to death your members. Now this is put come. I have, you have, we have to pass the test. And this is attainable if we allow the commander-in-chief to take over every reins of our hearts, yielded to him in pain and in the valley, in the mountains, in the plateaus of life. We must allow the commander-in-chief, Jesus Christ, to take control of this good cup and allow us to understand there is no shortcut. Now the person, as you can see, led to this, the desires of ourselves. Number one, you can see there is 5 points. It is number one, our attitude. Now the attitude, it is our way of behaving. It is our manner. It is the feeling of a negative attitude or disposition. So number one, you see, there is the attitude. Now the word put to death, you can see fornication, relationship outside marriage, is not become part of us. Impurity, he said, talk about the sexual area or passion or lust and shameful desire or evil desires. The Bible is very clear. Those things, Paul said, would never be heard from you already in the Lord. In other words, let it become a history. Cut it off. Never again touch those areas, because you were once dead and now you are alive with Jesus Christ. Live accordingly. See, so this kind of things is no longer for us. We don't want to touch other people in the context of the Western culture. Live in before marriage has become an acceptable norm. Impurity. There is an endless craving for something that is like, you know, they want to know more and more in this area, and that is something we could understand. People will never be able to be satisfied. There is an ongoing passion and desire that will never be sufficed by these physical things combined. It is only by the Lord. that is passion and lust. So, go to that. Another thing he said, you see the word there? And covetousness, takes note of the word, which is idolatry. The word covetousness, don't be greedy for the good things of this life. In other words, don't embrace so much the things that the world offers, lust of the flesh, lust of the eyes, and the pride of life, and the pleasure of sin for a season. Don't be greedy for good things of this life. It is equivalent to idolatry, and God hates idolaters. Very, very stinky to the Lord. The modern age, the Indian tries, you know, they have something in our mind. Our modern age, maybe in the context of Australia or America or England, the number one in our modern age, God in the nation of the rich nation is what? Number one. So maybe to from 50s or 80s or whatever, 40, whatever, 50 is money. It might be vacation every year. It might be investment, one after another investment. Or maybe every year I want to have to change my furniture every year. That's an option. It's not a problem. But you can see the world's desire, the craving is endless. Maybe every 3 years I have to change my car with a new one. And God become the God of today, even the Christendom, is only once a week, on a Sunday. But the 6 days is for their God that they crave and enjoy, and that is idolatry. And sad, it is not to rebuke, many people today are, with due respect to them, they don't read the Bible, they read other things. So they are ignorant. The problem is, I tell you what, without the Word of God, that's why put to death those things, without the Word of God, I tell you what will happen. There's gonna be a massive, massive home. There is no light at home, and all you need, you used to live many years ago, is being applied and become loose. Without the Word of God, the relationship in the family, of husband, wife, and children, and grandchildren, whatever it is messy. Once the Word of God is out, the old characteristic will be intensified because there is the presence of God, there is the Word of God, and God is only once away, and maybe fast away. The effect of that is a dangerous manifestation of what? An ugly home. So very, very important here. Covetousness here is, you know, greedy for the good things in life. Now, younger generation, you know, today is what? And all the kids, even the little ones, 3, 4 years old, they know the mobile phone or the iPad. They love all this iPad, they love all this wonderful kind of media instruments today, and movies and books and drugs that are common to our young people today. We're not rebuking there. And not only that, majority, that's why positively, we're praying for more young people. God is out in the agenda, in their agenda. God is out. Now, I wanted to say in verse 6, from idolatry, from the Christian context of the believers, and idolatry to the unbelieving people, and who are praying for them, and God understand them. The Bible says very clear, because of these things, plural, the wrath or anger of God is coming upon the sons of disobedience. There are many Christians who are disobedient, and so God said, I am angry with these people. My anger is coming to this disobedience. But I want you to understand here, God has no pleasure for people or called Christians, and this is not something that we have to care, who love to be controlled by this materialistic world of materialism and the pleasures of this world, demonic influence that are rampant in the Christian churches today, they are being gravitated instead of the presence of God and worship and things about the Word of God. They are moving to another direction, trying to satisfy themselves. And what happened? They are being controlled and led astray to walk farther and farther from the presence of God. But here's the good news. The grace of God is available. One thing to do is repent, come back to God, and then he says, for he will abundantly pardon. But permissible going on and on and on, and God is grieved. The Holy Ghost, don't grieve not the Holy Spirit. The Holy Ghost is grieved because darkness has God as the pleasure of darkness. The moment I continue to live in that, God is grieved like a mother, hurt deeply. The same thing, the Holy Spirit is hurt deeply because of the Christian living in a double standard life. God is on the million, even once a week. God is given me 2 hours once a week. See that? It's very sad. Again, Paul said, put to death. The word put to death is being unresponsive. Don't respond to those 5 things mentioned. Be unresponsive to sexual immorality, passion, lust, shameful desire, impurity, greed for the good things of this earth life. Don't respond. Don't give in. Don't open the door, in other words. You know what? We must have a daily decision, daily. Consciously cut off the disease or dried limbs or the main attraction in your life. Consciously, daily. Daily. Cut it off. We must have an active or action to